Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, we want to answer the age-old question of how to split a string in C++. I love my FlexiSpot Canna Pro Bamboo Standing Desk. So of course I said yes when the folks at FlexiSpot asked me if I wanted to do another sponsorship spot. This time, I got the FlexiSpot Pro Plus Standing Desk E7 with mahogany top and black legs. The Pro Plus E7 was easy to set up, very similar to the setup process for the Canna Pro. The E7 is very stable, comes in a wide range of widths, is nearly silent during use, and is less expensive than their competitors. The premium keypad is easy to use and program with 4 different presets available. And I'll just say from personal experience using this, it is very accurate and gets you back to the height that you last had it set to. Be sure to check out my exclusive referral link for a discount on your first purchase. Also, be sure to join the FlexiSpot Tech Day during September 7th through the 9th, 2022 for up to $200 off your purchase. Make sure you don't miss out, otherwise you'll have to wait for Black Friday to see such great deals again. So before we continue, I want to remind you again that episode ideas are driven by you on C++ Weekly, so be sure to go to the GitHub, propose video ideas, upvote, downvote, whatever you would like to see here. And also be sure to check out the video description for links to my C++ puzzle books and my C++ best practices book. Okay, so this is a question that has been asked for a very long time. If we look on Stack Overflow, this is 13 years ago and 5 months. And the most upvoted answers seem, shall we say, less than simple. If you look through this, you've got boost, string algorithm, string splitting questions using string stream as an option, which is less than ideal also. And, it just isn't a pretty picture. Now, on CBPcast a long time ago, someone pointed out to me that C++ 20 ranges actually solves this problem today. Okay, let's start with this simple boilerplate project. I'm using GCC trunk. This does require C++ 20 ranges, like I said. And well, I mean, yes, it is most of the way through 2022 right now, but compilers are still catching up on this whole ranges in C++ 20 thing in some cases here. But we're talking about the ranges that come with the standard library, not ranges v3, but you're welcome to check that out as well. So I can, in C++ 20, do this. And well, that works, at least in theory. I'm getting a compile time error because I set a value that I am not using. And well, that's true, I set the split strings. So it is important to know, first of all, that this is lazy evaluated. And now the second thing that you need to know is that we've just been given a range of ranges. And so if I want to output these things, I might do something like this, which works. We are actually able with format print to output these ranges of ranges. It works quite well. In fact, we get hello world C++ 20 exclamation point printed exactly as we wanted it to. Now that assumes that you have lib format available to you. If I wanted to do this, then I get a no match for these two things here. And this is a const ranges sub range, blah, 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 blah. Like it's a large type. So I can do this. I can manually construct a string view from the beginning to the end. And then the other question that we have to ask is, well, we've seen lib format, but what about format that's included with our standard library? And unfortunately, I can't really show you that right now because we don't have format included with our standard library yet from GCC. But that's okay. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at how this will get slightly better in C++ 23. We have an overload for string view construction where I can pass in this subrange and I will get a string view nice and helpfully out of it, and we can access that. That's awesome. This is so much better than doing something as simple as a string split used to be. And the code that's being generated is really honestly not so bad. Let's go ahead and get the IOStream cruft out of the way. And it's actually a very small binary that's been generated for us here. It's amazing, really. Everything in the ranges library is const expr capable. So I can do that, but this is actually going to cause a different compile time error. And it comes down to this. Since it's lazy evaluation, it needs to be mutated to actually do the execution here. So I don't currently think that there would be any advantage to creating like a static const expr lazy evaluated view of a thing. Maybe if it's a very complicated view, but I don't think so. Part of the problem is that you do have to make a copy of the thing. Now, granted, with C++ 23's auto capability, we can make this copy explicitly here and give it a copy that it can then mutate. But I don't think we've gained anything. But we can. I'm not going to actually dig into a specific use case here. But let's just say it's possible that compile time scripting parsing of things could be possible because we can use these things inside of const expr functions. We can create and use views inside of const expr functions, but not static const expr values inside of a const expr function. Anyhow, that just proves that we can use views in a const expr function. And yeah, there we go. Finally, a simple string split capability in C++ 20. A little bit more usable in C++ 23, and you have to be aware of the fact that you're getting a subrange back. So you have to do something intelligent with that. But thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe, and a like always helps.